If you watch my video about pollinator conservation, you'll know that I'm very passionate about pollinators. And not to play favorites, but bumblebees are definitely my favorite. So today I wanted to give you a little bit of information about bumblebees. Bumblebees are in the genus Bombus, and there are about 250 species worldwide, just a fraction of the 20,000 total species of bees in the world. They're found in all sorts of climates, from rainforest to the Arctic tundra. Seriously, there are bumblebees in the Arctic tundra. Like honeybees, bumblebees live in groups. They live in nests, often in burrows, which is much less organized than the honeybees you're probably familiar with. This is a red-tailed bumblebee nest, and you can see the disorganized wax pockets that are used to store pollen and used to house larvae. And unlike honeybees, bumblebee colonies die off before the winter, except for the queen, who lies dormant and then starts a new nest in the spring. In bumblebee colonies, females do most of the work, tending the larvae and finding food. When males are born, they generally leave the nest to find a queen to mate with and forage for their own food. Bumblebees also don't store a lot of food, so they're foraging constantly, unlike honeybees, which store a lot of honey in their hive. Bumblebees feed on all types of flowers, and you'll often find multiple species of bumblebee living in the same area. They may avoid competition because the different hives and species have evolved to feed on different types of flowers. Adorably, bumblebees also sometimes buzz flowers to get pollen. They use their flight muscles to shake the flower to loosen as much pollen as they can. Bumblebees, perhaps surprisingly, also play a really important role in agriculture. Some crops, like alfalfa and clover, require pollinators, and others are greatly improved by pollinators, like sunflowers and strawberries. For some crops, bumblebees are actually better pollinators than the ubiquitous honeybees. Tomato flowers require buzzing, the behavior that I mentioned, and clover flowers are too deep for the short tongues of honeybees. In fact, bumblebees are so effective at pollinating tomatoes that they have been bred just for that purpose. Though they're not as easy to transport as honeybee hives, over 1 million bumblebee nests are produced and sold every year. They are used in glasshouses on crops like tomatoes and sweet peppers. It is not an efficient model for large field crops, but in small glasshouses, it's very successful. This isn't, however, an effective plan for fixing the decreases in bee populations that we're experiencing. In honeybees, we have colony collapse disorder, but wild pollinators are disappearing as well. The rusty patch bumblebee, Bombus finis, once one of the more common bumblebees in North America, is now considered endangered. This is because of things like insecticide use, disease, climate change, and habitat loss. If you'd like to help bumblebees, you can support pollinator organizations like the Bumblebee Trust, and I'll include a link to a few of those in the description. You can also help by reporting bumblebee sightings to organizations like Bumblebee Watch and the Xerces Society. A little effort can do a lot to help these adorable little pollinators. I hope that you enjoyed this video and learned a little bit about bumblebees, aka the cutest bees. If you'd like more information about pollinators, check out my pollinator conservation video. I'm also planning a tutorial for how to make a solitary bee house later this year. And if you'd like to show off your love of pollinators with some Brilliant Botany merch, I've also included links to stickers, tote bags, and more in the description that all feature bees. Thanks so much for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.